Another procedure need to assist orthodontic treatment is called corticotomy assisted orthodontic treatment. Corticotomy defined as a liner cutting technique in the cortical bone. يعني نعمل فيشر or cutting through the bone. إذا تبعون هنا على الصور هذا هو الكاتينج. يستخدمون البيزو سيرجري أكثر شيء، ما يستخدمون الكونفنشنال بير، ممكن نستخدم بس أكثر شيء في كونفنشنال البيزو سيرجري. وهاي اللاين ممكن تكون فيرتيكال وممكن تكون هوريزونتال بالانتردنتال اريا تو افويد ذا دامج اوف ذا روت. واحيانا مجرد ان يسوون هولز، اذا تبعون هاي الهولز الموجوده هنا، هاي كلها يسموها كورتيكوتومي assisting the orthodontic treatment to accelerate or to produce acceleration for the tooth movement during the orthodontic treatment. الكورتيكوتومي تختلف عن الاوستيوتومي. الاوستيوتومي نسوي repositioning of the bone, setting the bone block posteriorly or anteriorly. بينما هنا مجرد ان نسوي liner cutting. البيولوجيكال ميكانيزم behind this procedure, it is a regional accelerator phenomena. يعني فد عملية تساعدنا على الهيلينج وتساعدنا على المور rapid movement of the root during the orthodontic treatment or during the movement of the they find after many studies that the rate of acceleration of the tooth movement and a human patient has been to be suggested 3 times the normal rate of the movement. يعني إذا سووا هاي العملية كورتيكوتومي فالحركة مالت الروت تكون ثلاث مرات أكثر من الحركة الطبيعية بدون هالعملية هاي. This accelerator effect has a finite period which is reported to be from 1 to 4 months. يعني هذا العملية اللي سووها إلى finishing time لعملية الأورثودونتيك تريتمنت يتراوح بين 1 إلى 4 أشهر. ممكن نسويها نرفع فلاب ونسوي cutting of the bone مثل ما تشوفون هنا بالصورة cutting of the bone elevated flap أو through the soft tissue cutting of the bone and the soft tissue directly to the area. This is okay. What are the indication of this procedure, corticotomy? Corticotomy is used to facilitate, as I told before, the orthodontic tooth movement and the healing and the rapid movement of the teeth during the conventional orthodontic treatment. So it is indicated in the long required duration. يعني الكيسات اللي تحتاج تايم طويل ممكن نقصر هذا التايم باستخدام this procedure. And limited tooth movement. يعني انت تسوي الأورثودنتيك بس ما تصير عندهم movement. And difficulties in producing movement in certain direction. يعني اكو بعض الدايركشن بالأورثودنتيك بها صعوبة في الحركة فيضطرون يستخدمون corticotomies. Clinical application for this procedure for the treatment of crowding, canine retraction after premolar extraction. يعني إذا الكناين موجود في مكان abnormal يعملون extraction للpremolar ويسوون retraction. Enhance post orthodontic stability after the treatment of teeth. Facilitate the eruption of impacted teeth. And facilitate orthodontic expansion of the jaw, سواء بالمرزلة أو بالماندبل. And molar intrusion and open bite correction also could be used. But this procedure is contraindicated in patient with active periodontal disease or gingival recession. يعني إذا المريض عنده periodontal قصية periodontitis and bone loss and when there is a gingival recession. To describe this procedure, as I told in the first slide, this operation or this assist procedure for orthodontic treatment, the surgical procedure of such alignment, we have various surgical intervention. The traditional corticotomy procedure entails the use of raising of a full thickness flap مثل ما قلنا قبل شوية, expose the bone then a vertical or horizontal cut with a depth or 0.5 millimeter or without joining these horizontal subapically. يعني the horizontal cutting should be done subapical especially for the premolar to avoid the damage to the periapical area and the loss of the vitality of the teeth, or the use of multiple holes. يعني cutting, والcutting ممكن يكون vertical or horizontal or combination or multiple holes in the bone facilitate the movement of these tooth. أكو more conservative technique اللي هو vertical interproximal soft tissue incision اللي هتشوفوه بالصورة, يعني ما يسوي فلاب مباشرة, يقطع داخل السوفت تيشو, يستخدمون البيزو سيرجيكال تيبس on a hand piece to cut the hard and the soft tissue. This is a more conservative technique. And after the surgery, orthodontic forces can be applied immediately or within 2 weeks after the surgery. يعني تقدر تشتغل أورثو مباشرة أو بعد أسبوعين حسب الإنديكيشن اللي تشتغل أنت. Complication of this procedure, possible complication includes adverse effect on the periodontium, the periodontal tissue, and adverse effect on the vitality of the pulp. قلنا تتذكرون قبل شوية قلنا الكاتنج لازم يصير سبابيكال بالنسبة إلى اللور to avoid the damage to the periapical area. Also, they found sometime root resorption might occur due to the effect of the head of another condition which need surgical intervention which assists the treatment, orthodontic treatment, is the removal of the frenum. And they called label frenectomy. فالفرينم بصورة عامة, it is a band or small band or fold of mucosal membrane that attach the lip and the cheek to the alveolar process and limit their movement. وكلكم you are or of us are familiar with the frenum. The maxillary midline frenum اللي هي mostly common frenum dealt with during orthodontic treatment connect the mucosa of the maxillary alveolar process and the central incisor to the upper lip. الفرينم إذا فحصناها بالميكروسكوب under microscope histologically it appeared to contain elastic fiber and collagen fiber. So two types are present in the frenum, elastic fiber and collagen fiber component. It is a dynamic structure. الفرينم يعتبروها dynamic structure. ليش؟ لأن change in the shape and the size and the position during the growth of the person or during the growth of the jaws. Histologically, they find that collagen fiber of the labial frenum, collagen fiber, more elastic fiber, disrupt the transseptal periodontal membrane. شوفوا هاي الفايبر اللي موجودة هنا رقم 7 يسموها transseptal periodontal membrane. فإذا الفرينم attached to this area going to disturb or disrupt the transseptal periodontal fiber of the central incisor which related to the formation of SBS called diastema. يعني الإفكت مال الفرينم بالcentral incisor due to the effect on the disruption of transseptal. For the treatment of diastema which is present already in the anterior part of the jaw called diastema, the space between the central incisor, it need a surgical removal before the end of the orthodontic treatment because it is a hypertrophic tissue inhibiting the closure of this space. They find that also, although the removal of it is important for the treatment of diastema, but other studies or rare studies find that abundant granulation tissue may be formed in the area after the removal of the frenum. Some abundant granulation tissue may complicate diastema closure. يعني تمنع الكلوجر of the diastema. Frenectomy is mean that total removal of the frenum could be done by various surgical procedure. The first procedure called simple excision technique, removal of the frenum. Second, Z-blasty technique for the treatment of the frenum. And the third method called localized vestibuloplasty with secondary vitalization. And the last one, the use of the laser-assisted frenectomy, removal of the frenum by the use of the laser, not by the using of the scalpel. ورحنا نشرح كل. The first method used for the removal of the frenum called simple excision technique. إذا توقعون هاي الصور اللي هنا يمكن تشوفكم البروسيجر. ف already or usually done under local anesthesia, infiltration, and a narrow elliptical incision around the frenum. هاي الفرينم هنا يعملون two elliptical incision, one medial and one distal to the frenum, deep to the periosteum. Then a dissection for the removal of this band of the tissue with the mucosa. With undermining of the tissue. إذا تشوفون هنا هذا السيزر they show undermining to facilitate the reapproximation of the tissue. After that we start to put the suture. The first incision the first suture should be placed deeply to the maximal depth of the vestibule. هذا أول واحد تشوفون هنا اللي أشر عليه. هذا نخيط بالميكوزا and down to the periosteum and the mucosa on the other side. فهذا راح يحدد لنا الدبث مالت الفيستيبيول. Then we continue for the other sutures as in this image. The second method for the frenectomy is called Z-blasty technique. And this is a famous technique used for removal of the frenum. In this technique, the excision of the frenum is done as in the previous technique. يعني الفرينم نشيلها بطريقة simple excision. After that, two oblique incision is made in a Z fashion at the end of the previous area. إذا تبعون هنا, يعني بعد نسوينا removal إلى Z plasty, عفوا إلى الفرينم بالsimple excision. نعمل two incision with about 60 degree angulation, not vertical or acute, 60 degree. إذن أصبح الشيب زد بلاستي. إذن أصبحت عندنا حاليا two flap. This is one and this is one. You have to rotate this in this area and you have to rotate this area and this area. And you have to do a suturing. The two flaps are then undermining and rotated in a close the initial vertical incision horizontally. Z-blasty is usually indicated in a frenum or for a frenum with a wide crystal attachment. يعني لما يكون الattachment مالته بالcrystal of crystal part of the alveolus and shorter alveolus height. يعني ال vestibule يكون عندهم short because it increase the alveolar height. إذن هذا الانديكيشن مهم لازم واحد ينتبه له. When we have wide crystal attachment and shorter vestibule. And this operation is ideal when there is a broad and thick hypertrophic frenum. Thick, broad and hypertrophic frenum associated with diastema of the central incisor and short vestibule. هذا الكلام طبعا مهم. بالنسبة للإنديكيشن مالت الزد بلاستي. It is a more demanding procedure. يعني يستخدموها هواية. But it is a result in a less scar for information ويعتبرونها من العمليات اللي يكون السكار بها قليل. The third method for the treatment of frenum called localized vestibuloplasty with secondary epithelialization. This type of surgery is indicated for wide frenal attachment. إذا تبعون هاي الصورة frenum wide attachment. Okay. An incision is made through the mucosa tissue and underlining submucosal tissue. إذا تشوفون هنا V shape incision هذا المكان. بعد ذلك نسوي dissection للميكوزا والسب ميكوزا to the periosteum ونعمل undermining. من نعمل undermining راح نحصل على الصورة التالية. This is the third step. After that we are going to طبعا الدايسكشن يصير سبرا بريوستيال يعني ما البريوستيال ما نسوي بي دايسكشن يبقى covering the bone undermining the mucosal and submucosal and the edge of the mucosa إذا هذا المكان اللي تباون عليه you have to suture it to the periosteum in the deepest part of the vestibule. Okay, the other part exposed part going to be epithelialized by secondary epithelialization, covered with gauze or iodoform gauze to be epithelialized. إذن معظم المكان هذا نقدر نخيط الميكوزا والسبميكوزا تريبريوستيوم. If there is exposed area of periosteum, you have to leave it to secondary epithelialization. هاي الطريقة يسموها localized vestibuloplasty. With secondary vitalization and used for wide frenal attachment condition. The last method used for the frenectomy is the use of the laser and other tools for surgery. Nowadays it is the widely used. Frenectomy by laser can be performed by laser. اللي هو ممكن يكون دايود ليزر او نادوديوم ليزر ياج او اورجون ياج او سي اوتو اللي هو اكثر شيء يستخدمون السي اوتو ليزر سبيشالي فور ذا سوفت تيشو. اذا هنا تباون بالصوره تقدروا تباون. The main advantage of this method by using of laser it is less bleeding during the surgery. عمل لنا هيموستيسيس بالمكان. No need for suturing. ما نحتاج نسوي suture لأن راح يسوي ablation of the tissue. No need for periodontal dressing. ما نحتاج لا كوباك ولا iodoform gauze. Minimal post-operative swelling and discomfort. Discomfort post-operative discomfort يكون قليل. إذا تباعون بهاي الصورة هذا epithelial أو frenum wide frenum. وهنا ندى يستخدم الليزر ده يسوي الablation. يعني يحرق التشو. وهذا صورة ثانية ممكن تقدرون تباعون. هذا هو the use of the laser during the surgery. Ablation of the area. يتركوها تشوفين وراء أسبوعين أو عشرة أيام يصير complete epithelialization with the disappearance of the